okay, Tuck? Now you kids better wake up now. We need to discuss Trey's birthday, which is coming up much faster than you think.
Trey's birthday? Oh my gosh, we can't forget that. When is it, honey?
Tomorrow!
Well, that certainly doesn't give you much time to get ready. What are you gonna do? Well, we definitely need to make him some kind of cake. And get him some presents. Something, you know, he really likes. Let's see. Oh, licorice whips. He loves those. Not sure if he actually eats them, but he loves to use them as bull whips when we play Indiana Jones.
Yeah, he's one mean kitten with a whip.
Ew, I always hated it when Trey ate licorice. His teeth and the inside of his mouth would get so black and his breath would smell like burnt plastic, which is exactly what licorice tastes like. Wow, that's weird. I still have a gag reflex. Who knew?
That's what she said. Wait, is that the correct use of that?
I don't know. Why are you asking me? Do I look like the feline Don Rickles or something?
Well, you certainly know Joan Rivers.
Now, honey, it's perfectly normal to have the same kind of reactions you did when you were alive, even though you don't have the same reasons for them anymore. It's sort of like having a flashback.
Oh, I know about flashbacks, believe me. When I was going through mental pause, I had a bunch of... Oh, wait, I'm sorry. That wasn't a flashback. It was a hot flash. I think I'm having one now.
So, Tippy, what are you getting Mr. Trey as a present?
Maybe I'll get him a game we can all play.
What kind of game?
Oh, that's a good idea. Trey loves games. Mental games, mostly, but I think a board game would be fine.
Maybe Mousetrap? Or Operation? Or something with the Pop-O-Matic? I love those.
You know, I once had a Pop-O-Matic pancake maker, which in theory sounds great. But once you pop the top to flip them, the darn things would pop right into the plastic, which meant there was batter and partially cooked pieces all over the place. It was a complete mess. Not very practical, neither.
Oh, I know a fun game to play. Tag, you're it.
What? I don't want to play tag. We're supposed to be planning Trey's birthday.
Are you saying you can't multitask? Come on, Tippy.
You know, I used to dabble in filmmaking back in college. Maybe I can make a special little birthday video for Trey.
What a great idea.
Tag, you're in.
Got you back. I thought you weren't playing.
Well, like Courtney Cox, Laura Dern, and Christina Aguilera, I changed my mind.
Well, as I say, it's your prerogative. But remind me, who is Laura Dern again? Didn't she used to be on Saturday Night Live?
No, that was Nora Dunn. Gotcha.
Oh, right. She's the MGM musical star that sang Honeysuckle Road.
Lena Horne.
The famous Southern cook?
That's Paula Deen.
Then who's Laura Dern?
Laura Dern is the daughter of Bruce Dern, the go-to guy when you're looking to cast a criminal, psychotic, or sociopath. But Laura herself was in a string of popular movies in the 80s and 90s, including the Jurassic Park trilogy. But perhaps she'll best be known as the woman Ellen came out to on the groundbreaking I Am Lesbian Hear Me Roar episode of the old Ellen sitcom. Now can we please get past Laura Dern already?
Tag, you're it.
Oh yeah? Got you back.
Guess this isn't so difficult when we confine ourselves to this tower, huh? Gotcha.
Not really. Got you back.
So maybe tag isn't the right name for this game. Maybe we should call it Whack-a-Tippy.
How about Punch the Spot?
There's nothing I love more than a little roughhousing with the female I love.
Careful. That's what got Charlie Sheen in trouble. And Chris Brown and Liza Minnelli.
Oh, I didn't mean it like that. I would never hurt or bully Tippy. But I do love it when she plays a little rough. Right, me precious?
Right. Gotcha.
Oh, what fright at yonder window breaks. That was a pun. So Tippy it should be mooned.
Spot Punzel, let down your golden tail.
Was that a mashup of Shakespeare and the Brothers Grimm? Just because they do that kind of stuff on Glee each week does not mean you need to do it too.
We're not doing a mashup. We're visually illustrating why nothing ever gets done in Washington. Too much fighting and jockeying for position.
Oh, I thought we were playing the Hatfields and the McCoys.
Same thing.
That's what's so maddening. If only politicians would take the billions of dollars they raise in campaign contributions and put it into something more long-lasting than a glorified beauty contest.
I agree, it's a waste. That money could be helping millions of people instead of just one.
Listen, I hate to interrupt this episode of The View, but can we please get back to Trey's birthday?
Sorry, honey, you know how politics gets my spots in a stir. But you're right, we should be discussing Trey's birthday.
You know, the next time you want to discuss someone's birthday, you might want to make sure they're not in the room first.
Boo!
Well, that idea bombed. So much for keeping the element of surprise.
Honey, have you really been there the whole time? Why didn't you say anything?
Well, at first I thought you were kidding, that you really knew I was here and you were just saying all that stuff for my benefit. But then when I slowly realized you didn't have a clue, it was too late.
Oh, come on! You should know by now we never have a clue! Wait. Did I just say that right?
Let me make one thing perfectly clear. I don't want a birthday party, okay? So you can stop all your planning and plotting. Tomorrow is just gonna be a day like any other.
Right! No birthday party. Gotcha! No problem. Yeah, look, that's gonna stop me from planning the bestest birthday party Mr. Trey ever had. And he's gonna like it, too. And now you too can own your very own collection of Cat Clips coffee mugs, so you can wake up every morning to coffee, caffeine, and some comical cat quips. To order, just go to wizardofwit.com.